figured it out from black and white. Did they ever hold each other tight like us? Did they ever fight like us? Saw the mistakes of up and down, meet in the middle.
How can I die fully in pain without being dramatic? Alone?
Get out of my kitchen!
Sexy nose.
Write me a tattoo. Write me a tattoo. And I'm like, okay, what?
1 billion to the bitches in the house.
Obviously, there's no truth to it. Obviously.
You alright?
Harry.
She's nothing like a girl you've ever seen before. Nothing you can compare to your neighborhood. I'm trying to find the words to describe this girl without being disrespectful. The way that booty moving, I can't take no more. Had to stop what I'm doing so I can pull.
You and me were raised in the same part of town. Got these scars on the same ground. Remember how we used to kick around, just wasting time.
Won't you stay to the end? All my favorite conversations always made in the end. Cause we don't know what we're saying. We're just swimming round in our glasses and talking out of our asses like we're all gonna make it. Yeah, yeah.
Feels like this could be forever right now. Don't wanna sleep cause we're dreaming out loud. Trying to behave but you know that we never learn how. You and me were raised in the same part of town.
This is part 30 of one of these stories you might not know about, and I've been doing a lot of really serious ones of these, so I thought I'd lay in the mood a little bit today. I saw someone on Twitter asking what the replay game was, so I thought I'd explain that. Obviously, the boys were really young when they banned, so they probably got bored with all of the, like, serious stuff they had to do in their job, because it still was a job. So they had a game they'd play in interviews called the replay game. It's pretty self-explanatory about the game. One of the guys would say replay, and the guy who had said something would have to repeat their sentence. Here's an example.
I'll tell you.
They would do this in a lot of interviews, and it was just a way to make it more fun, considering when you think about it, they probably had to answer the same questions over and over again, like, all day. Here's another one, just for fun.
Yeah, Harry made that up.
Replay.
It's great.
Yeah, Harry made that up.
Excuse me, replay to my own.
Excuse me, yeah, Harry made that up. Yeah.
I've got no roots, but my home was never on the ground. I've got no roots, but my home was never on the ground. I've got no roots. I've got no roots.
If you're not here to get me through it all, I let my guard down and then you pull.
I'm going under in this time. I fear there's no one to turn to. This all or nothing way of loving.
But if you loved me, why'd you leave me? Take my body, take
So we all know that if a One Direction reunion does happen, that tickets are probably going to sell out in approximately 30 seconds. So here is a list of people that I do not think should be allowed to buy tickets. First one is OT4s, even though if it happened, Zayn probably wouldn't be there. They're still not invited. Next is people that say, oh, Simon Cowell isn't that bad. Or, but they wouldn't even have careers if it wasn't for Simon. You're not invited. Next is people that hate on Liam, because that's like so self-explanatory. Like, how? No. Next is people that don't know the No Control dance. Sorry, just, it's like a few moves. Just learn it. If you don't know it, learn it. Otherwise, no invite. Also, I promise I'm not mean. It's very serious when it comes to the One Direction reunion.
Me waiting for someone to casually fall in love with me while staying in my bedroom all day. You got games on your phone. 7 billion smiles in the world, but yours are my favorite. Niall is a Larry ASF, prove me wrong. Touch your hair if Larry is real. If Larry is real, touch your nose. Harry looks like he's being punished, but he's so cute. Don't talk to me. Niall is ugly. You have 3 seconds to run. Mom, who sold the house me at the One Direction reunion concert? Harry Styles at on the beach is a different species. Friend, who's your boyfriend? Me, Harry Styles' friend. I mean real me, at real_Liam_pain friend. I mean official me, at Niall official friend. For God's sake, I mean out of 1D me, Zayn friend.
Ver, a ver, a ver.
I caught it bad just today. You hit me with a call to your place.
Ooh.
Ain't been out in a while anyway. Was hoping I could catch you throwing smiles at my face.
Romantic talking, you don't even have to try. You're cute enough to fuck with me.
Hola.
Looking at the table, all I see is bleeding white. Baby, you live in a life.
Oh, so hard.
Cocaine, oh. You with your friends. You live in a dark, boy, I cannot pretend. I'm no fake, don't make it a sin. If you ain't in your garden, you know that you can. Call me when you want, call me when you need. Call me in the morning, I'll be on the way. Call me when you want, call me when you need. Call me out by your name, I'll be on the way. Like,
well, let's go to the mall.
Okay.
All right, I'll drive.
Put y'all seatbelts on.
Psh, YOLO.
Guess the One Direction song by the Emojis.
One Direction references in TV shows part 2.
Hey, that's my One Direction pillow. I mean, no it's not.
You interrupted my dream about a shoe store owned and operated by One Direction. Harry was about to size my foot.
It would be a shame if I accidentally sent out that video I took of you on the day Zayn left One Direction.
Hey, Uncle Will, why are you crying?
Zayn left the band. He was the sensitive one.
Everyone else but you. She walked away.